Okay. All right. We're going to go ahead and start. You know now, it's hard for me to pronounce your name. Can you pronounce your name one more time for me? Pronounce your name.
Masejo.
Masejo. My husband, he's good at those foreign names. I would butcher your name. So
okay.
Hopefully this young lady will come in later. I hope she do, because she really, really needs to be delivered. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. It's good. I'm talking to Alarisa, that I never received a response from that young man. So if so happened he contact you, you need to let him know about the FCC app and email me for a date and time so we can get together at Alarisa. Okay. So now what you're experiencing. You're experiencing movement in your body, in your belly. I'm talking
you're
to you.
You're talking to me?
Yeah, I'm talking to you now. Let's see that.
Okay.
Okay, I'm
yeah.
I'm going to listen out your name.
Okay, you can just spell it out. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, it's been quite a while since I have been experiencing some movement in my belly.
Mm-hmm.
I would say since last year I became aware of the movement. It would be as if this heartbeat, like something is beating inside my stomach.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
yeah, and then.
Yeah, but the thing is, God didn't live for you. Few weeks ago he delivered you and the Lord will tell
yeah.
you how that thing got back. You wonder how did it get back into you. So I'm going to tell you why. Now,
okay.
Your clothes. Every garment you got that, you know, when you wear those garments, you feel sexy in them and you look sexy. You have to get rid of those clothes because that spirit snake is wrapped tied all around those clothes. That's lust. So by you having those clothes, and you have no clothes, any clothes that you put on that you feel sexy and look sexy, any clothes, it don't matter. If you put clothes on and you feel like you're sexy and you look sexy.
I do have like
and
short skirts. Is that what you're referring to, like short skirts, something
like that? It don't matter. Any clothing that you put on, whether it's short or long, that shows the shape of your body, the curves, your curves, and you know you look sexy. People even, you know, comment you on looking good, looking sexy. Any clothes that you got that makes you feel look sexy, you have to get rid of those clothes. Also, photographs. You know, God's daughters on Facebook, they love to post selfies on Facebook, especially if you got those photographs that you're taking before your deliverance. Those spirits
yeah.
are still in those photographs. In the photographs you got, you take that you took before your deliverance, where you posing sexy, you look sexy. The garments shows your shape. You're showing your cleavage. You're just showing your body form. It's form fitting. In the clothing, it's form fitting. And that opens the door for those spirits to come back because such garments belong to the enemy. So you have to get rid of those garments, and then those photographs, you have to destroy those photographs. That's why I tell a lot of God's daughters when they get delivered, go on Facebook, you need to remove those photographs and destroy them because that spirit is captured in those photographs, even in those photographs. That is
okay,
an open door.
Can I ask you, like, talking about clothes, like, I have tight jeans,
tight jeans?
Yeah, like tight.
Yeah, that's why you wear them tight. You wear them tight so that your shape of your butt can show. So your body form can show. That's why you wear the tight jeans. That's sin, that's lust. That keeps you bound to lust, and your lookers bound to lust. Those such clothing belongs to the end. The Lord has told his daughter to dress modest. That means we don't dress to show our shape. And we just don't wear sexy clothes. The world say wear sexy clothes to look sexy. That's the world. We're not of the world. We're in the world, but we're not of the world. But if we continue to conform ourselves to pattern ourselves after the world, then the God of this world will enter us. And that's why that it's a theme of spirit. It looks like a snake. And because of that love, when it gets into a person, male or female, you actually will really eventually feel their movement. They will move around in you. That's what happened to me before I got delivered. So that was the open door. Such clothing, you have to get rid of it. And those photographs on your Facebook that you pose where you can see your form fitting, your shape, you see your cleavage. Those photographs, you've got to take them down because those spirits are captured in those photographs. And why think people, men and women too, is prone to go to certain people profile because of their profile pictures, because of their pictures that they take. And believe me, I see a lot of God daughters, you know, with that spirit snaking them, taking those selfies, and they always got to turn the side so you can see their butt. That's because that spirit is in them. They need deliverance. So that's how that spirit got back into you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I need to get rid of my clothes.
Clothes that make you feel sexy, make you feel and look sexy. That's the reason why you got them, because you look sexy. You know, not clothes that, you know, that you look okay in. But these are sexy clothes, clothes that make you feel and look sexy. Those types of clothes.
Yeah, clothes that reveal my body. That's actually what you mean, tight.
Yeah,
For example, things like skinny jeans, like, are they
skinny jeans?
They're not okay.
That's why they wear skinny jeans, because they fit tight. They fit tightly, and they show you. Why do you think you got them? Because they show the form of your shape. That's why you got them. Skinny jeans shows the form of it. Now, of course, there's some women who are skinny, and that's why they get them, to show their skinny body. And there's some women who ain't skinny, and they still get them to show their fat body, which they think they're skinny, but they ain't. In fact, in either case, you show on the shape of your body. That's the purpose. Now, I remember when I was coming up, I had a nice little shape there when I was a young girl, because I had babies now, that my shape ain't like it was when I was young. And I was proud of my shape. And at that time, I was not sexual active, but I loved my shape. I knew I looked good, so that was just one dress I bought. I only had that one dress I bought. It was form-fitting, and when I wear it, it would just shape my body, and you could just see my curve, my butter, you know, just see the shape, and I loved it. And I loved to go outside, especially when the men was around, so they could see it and say, "You sure look good in it." I say, "Thank you." I loved that. It was compliments. Now, I wasn't a Christian, but that one dress I loved, and that's the reason why I wore it. One day, I did it. And outside, I did, this boy said, "Terry, that is lust." I was shocked. I was like, "What? That is lust." I said, "Oh, God." I said, "Oh, forgive me, Lord." And I went home and threw that dress away, never wore a dress like that since. And I wasn't even a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
I said, "That is lust." It's lust. Why do you think a woman, you know, wear clothing that where their body shapes and show? I said, that is lust. And you're going to get what you're calling, which is that spirit. That spirit, then the spirit looks like a snake, and that thing enters you, and it crawls in your body. And that's why you begin, that's why you feel the movement, because that is lust. It's a sexual demon. And that's how that spirit got back into you. Because you still wasn't. Now, if somebody look at you now, yes, they wouldn't think you dress like that. But that's not the way you dress. You just dress like that because you're cold. You know, but you don't go by the looks, but you see, you go by the Holy Ghost. So again, you get rid of all those garments that you know when you put them garments on, that you look sexy and you love the compliments from the men and the women too, telling you you look beautiful. And you get rid of those garments. Photograph that you got on your Facebook or whatever other social media where you have profile pictures. If those pictures, you took those pictures before your deliverance, and you look at it and you see yourself in those sexy clothes and sexy poses, you better get rid of them because you don't. That spirit don't leave. But if you don't obey God, it's coming back because you asked to send it back. When we refuse to give up what belongs to them, they say that is their property and they're going to be where their property is. And if people ask you, why did you change the way you dress? Well, God changed me. I learned that that was not, the way I dressed was not of God. It did not glorify God. God told us to dress modest. And whether you realize or not, when a woman dressed like that, men may smile at you and say, oh girl, you look sexy. But do you know they would not have you as a wife? They would not choose you as a wife. They could choose someone who dressed modest. Ain't that something? They'll tell the woman she looks sexy and what she got on, but when they get come down to marry, they'll go find a woman that dresses modest and marry her.
Okay. Can I ask you something? Like, if, let's say, like, I wear a jean, because most of my jeans is, like, most of my clothes is skinny jeans. Let's say I wear that and with a long shirt. Is it still fine? Or
it's not going to work because you know why? Your mind is going to be conscious of how you still look down below. Because I had another young girl who asked that, and I told her, but she went and did it anyway. And she found out it didn't work. That spirit still attacked her. Because in your mind, you know what's there. Because that particular garment belongs to the enemy. So your mind is always conscious on it. And that's just, it's sin. Like I messaged a limb to this one lady. She got rid of all her sexy clothes except for one item she had on. Lingerie that she really loves sleeping in. A sexy lingerie she loves sleeping in. So she kept it. So she notified me not too long after and told me her story. She said, I put that thing on. She said, that night the devil tormented me. He raped me. And the Lord woke me up and said, get up and take it off. And she said, I got up that thing and took that thing off and threw it away.
So I need to throw them away. Like, I can't donate them.
No, you don't give someone else sin, your sin. Leave them in the door. Yeah. And I had another woman to ask that, can I give? I said, no, you don't do that. Why are you going to mislead your sister like that? You know it's wrong.
Okay, so let me ask, if I keep them in my room but not wear them. Maybe like, let's say I put them in a bag and then I put them away. Because right now I'm in dress. I'm in student hostel, so I can burn them when I go back home. Is it still fine? For as long as I don't wear them.
So
I should burn them right now.
Where you at? You're not allowed to throw anything away in the trash bin.
No, I'm afraid, like, if I threw them away in the trash bin, like, they might take them and then they don't know.
Well, what you do is you get some scissors. And one by one, you cut them up. They never, nobody's going to, you're not going to mislead anybody because I'm cutting it up in Jesus' name. And know that Jesus is with you. Now, when you start cutting them up and you start hearing a strange noise or sound, Lord said, don't let them lie you. The devil's just mad, but it cannot touch you. Okay? Because you don't want to just keep the devil's property around you like that, because he's going to be where his property is.
Mm.
So as soon as you can, you get rid of him. Okay? But there are some things that was made for destruction. And that was their purpose. You'd be surprised of this Satanist designers. You'd be surprised to know that most designers are Satanists, and they get their ideals from devils concerning, creating and designing their clothes and their intent and purpose. And then the people go out and buy them, all because maybe it's the trend, it's the popular. They don't know spiritually what's behind it. So anytime you go shopping for your clothes, you always ask the Holy Ghost, because he knows where that item been. He knows everything about that item. Because you'd be surprised of people that literally go to shops and just put their hands on an item and curse it. So that the next person who purchased it, they will suffer. So if we naive about these things and think that these things are not happening, we don't inquire the Holy Ghost, and when we buy those things and bring it home, then we start being tormented. We wonder, well, what is going on here? Why? And that is why. That's why we should inquire after the Holy Ghost. You know, they had this show in America a while back about it was a paranormal show about cursed items. And I watched it to learn, and I really saw from those clips how most items are cursed, and people don't pay no attention to it. They don't even pray over it. You just go and try to close them. You better pray over those clothes before you put them on, because the devil's people is nasty. They will leave little droplets of blood on that clothing in hopes that you come in contact with it and get disease. They do stuff like that. So we always acquire the Holy Ghost. And my daughter had, I told her that, and she was good at it, but one day she didn't do it. She got an item, she didn't pray over it, and she was wondering why in the world she was getting agitated and upset. And I said, what is wrong with you, girl? And then she realized how I acted towards her to wake her up, and she thought about it, and then the Holy Ghost told her, you didn't pray over that item that you brought here. And she said, oh, that's right, I sure did. And she went back and she prayed over it. So you just go up and do stuff, be doing stuff. You better check on the Holy Ghost.
Okay.
And you go buy your clothing. Okay?
Mm. Yeah.
So that's how that spirit got back into you.
Okay, because I agree, like, I have, I would say, like, 90% of my clothes, it's just sexy clothes. So.
I know. The Lord told me that. I'm telling you. That's why everybody look at you now, they're going to say, oh, she don't dress like that. That is not the way she dressed, everybody. Cold. If she wasn't cold, you'd see a different person. You'd be like, oh, that's her. Yes, that would be her.
Yeah,
the Holy Ghost knows.
And I used to love lingerie. Like, I used to. Like, with all my heart, like, I wouldn't get into a shop and then get out without buying them.
Mm-hmm. It's that of that spirit, snake. It's that spirit to keep you bound to lust. And not only you bound to lust, but your lookers, male and female, when they look on you, be bound to lust. Mm-hmm. That's the reason why. So Lord wanted you to know. He set you free. But he set you free. Whenever I remind the Father who's with me doing on earth, he does it in heaven. And I know he do it. Now, it's up to us to maintain and keep our together. And sometimes we just, unknowledgeable of truth.
Okay.
But he saw your heart. And that's why he sent you back, so that you can be knowledgeable. Now you know. See, it's a truth that you know will set you free. Mm. So now you know the truth. So if anybody asks you, you just need to tell them the truth. Say, look, I need to dress for Jesus. The way I would dress was for the devil. It wasn't for Jesus. It did not glorify the Lord. It glorified the devil in me. That was sin. It was an open door. Okay? And just want to go ahead. And don't forget now, on your Facebook, it's on your Facebook too, all those pictures. All those pictures. A bunch of them, but yeah. And I don't say I've been up there looking, though. I don't know about it. All I know is there's just a bunch of them up here. You get rid of those things because those spirits was captured.
Yeah.
And when you go back and look, like this one sister, and the Holy Spirit going to open your spiritual eyes, you actually going to see that spirit in those photos. You'll be like, oh, I didn't notice this before. You actually see that spirit.
Because, you know, something happened after the deliverance. Like, I went onto Facebook. I had this profile picture where I was, like, wearing a short tight dress.
Mm-hmm.
Suddenly, like, I didn't comfortable with that picture. I removed it immediately, but I didn't delete it. I just changed the password and just, like, put a decent selfie picture. I removed that sexy picture and stuff.
So in other words, instead of deleting it, you removed it as your profile and put another picture. That's what you're saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, you need to remove them. Delete them. Delete them. And if you got hard copies, you need to tear them up, even the hard copies of pictures. Any pictures you're taking before your deliverance, they're going to have that spirit snake in there. You need to destroy them. Destroy them all. And take new pictures, dressing modestly. And you can post them. That way when people look on it, they'll see Christ in you. And not the devil in you. Okay?
Mm. Okay.
Praise God. All right. So there's your answer. So, no, hold on a second. Carla. Can you hear me, Carla?
Carla and Carla what?
Carla. Can you hear me, Carla?
Carla.
Carla. Carla, can you hear me? Carla.
Hello? I'm sorry. Somebody just called me.
Hey, I just brought you on. Somebody just called you. Now, are you in a position to talk? Oh, I get work.
Yeah, I can talk. I'm at home.
Are you at home? Could you come on video?
Yes. I'm trying to figure out.
Come on video because I want you to do this deliverance on my sister.
Okay.
Okay. You know, it's good. It's good God sent me some help. You know, I can rest and enjoy. Yeah, that's the way it's supposed to be. It don't matter the same Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost is me, Holy Ghost is her, he's the one who does it. Yeah, that's all that matters.
Okay. He's allowed video access.
Okay. Then the video is off. So you have to turn it on. You never been on video up here, have you?
No, I haven't.
Okay. Matsiko.
Hello.
Okay,
my video.
I'm going to disconnect and come back on.
Okay, no.
I don't know why.
Okay, I'll go and see. Okay, yeah. Well, Do that right quick. You're going to come back on.
All right.
Okay. We wait till she come on. I'm gonna get her to do it. She done another deliverance for me. God used her mightily. Remember now, it's the same Holy Ghost. You don't get attached to the vessel that God used. So God can one day can take the vessel away, and God is always here by His Holy Spirit. Okay?
Okay.
So we're waiting around for a caller to come over here. Okay?
Okay.
And my other sister, you all continue to keep her in prayer. She's in Namibia. I know the enemy stopped her. The enemy can't stop what God is doing, but he can handle God's child. And God's child can stop it. So my intercessors, when they come on, they never know when I'm going to call them to do this work. You keep tuning in, Brother Ellis. Keep showing me your faithfulness. Keep tuning in. One day I'm going to call on you. You're short. Okay, let's see here. Let me see. All right. We're back in, Carla. So, my figure, whenever you came on, what did you do to find your video?
I clicked on the right top. There's a video icon.
Okay, top, the top right, Carla. I think you see an icon.
Yeah, but I'm using a cell phone, so I don't know on the PC.
Your problem might be the same, I think.
Yeah.
Say something, Carla, see if I can hear you. Okay, I can hear you now.
It keeps saying please allow video access on your browser, but I don't know how I can call.
Anyway, all right. Well, I'm still going to let you go ahead and do it. We just won't be able to see your face. Okay, so just go ahead
Okay.
And M-A-S-E-G-O, you just keep your mind on Jesus and be saying, thank you, Jesus, for setting me free. Because remember, Jesus is right there where you are. He's right where I am at. He's right there where you are. Okay? Now,
okay.
Turn your camera where you can be. You sideways. You sideways. You sideways.
Am I okay now?
You're upside down now. There you go.
No?
That's right. You're right there. Yeah. So you just thank you, Jesus. Because remember, Jesus is the deliverer. I'm not the deliverer. Carl is not the deliverer.
Okay.
Jesus is the deliverer. So within yourself, you be saying, thank you, Jesus, for setting me free. Okay? Amen. All right, Sister Carla.
Okay. Heavenly Father, I just thank you for this opportunity.
Yes.
We thank you for this opportunity to come together, Lord God. And you said,
yes,
where two or three are gathered in my name, I'm in the midst. So, Lord, we thank you that you are right here in the midst of us, Lord God.
Mm-hmm.
You are the true deliverer. And thank you, Lord, that you found it right to use us as vessels to minister to our dear sister, Masejo, Lord God.
Mm-hmm.
We thank you, Lord, for giving her information, knowledge and wisdom through Evangelist King that will help her to stay free in the name of Jesus. Lord, I just praise you right now for my dear sister, Lord God, that she did not, she was not too proud to come back and ask for help.
Yes, Lord.
And get delivered again, Lord God. She really wants to serve you in spirit and in truth, Lord. So, Father, I just thank you, Lord, for this work that you're about to do. I thank you, Father, that you have given us the power to bind and to loose.
Yes,
whatever
Lord.
We bind on earth, Lord, it shall be loose. I mean, bound in the heaven, and whatever we loose on earth is loose in heaven as well.
Yes, Jesus.
nor will speak concerning any door that the enemy has opened, that was never your will to be opened or reopened. And we say to those doors right now in the name of Jesus to close in the name of Jesus. And they're sealed in the name of Jesus, never to be opened or reopened again.
Yes, ma'am.
And every door that was closed to my sister Masejo that was never meant to be closed, we command right now in the atmosphere that they be open in the name of Jesus.
Yes, ma'am.
Father, right now, just thank you.
Amen.
Right now.
Amen.
I speak right now. So, Spirit husband, you heard everything that I said.
Mm-hmm.
Spirit
sure
of hate. Spirit of lust. You heard every single word that I just said. Right now, we bind you right now in the name of Jesus. And every single spirit that you allow to come back into my system, you take and snatch and grab every single one of them. Take them right now, all of them. All of them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every single one of them, you take them and you bind them around your waist like a bell rope. Take them all. Take them all out. All out.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Holy Ghost fire, I call upon you to go forth right now into my sister's mind. And I ask for that you burn. Holy Ghost fire, burn in her mind right now. Every spirit that is not of the Holy Spirit, burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. Get out. Get out of God's house. Get out of her mind.
Get out of her mind
right now. In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus.
She was not holding on to her anymore. In the name of Jesus Christ. She looked at those clothes. She would see that evil. She would see that lust. And she would have no problem cutting up things up and getting rid of them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Because she is going to be set free in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire, I ask right now that you just go right now into her ears and her hearing. Every lying spirit that's telling her it's okay. This outfit is fine. This is no. We bind you right now and we command you to shut up in Jesus' name. Silence in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, I thank you right now that you're going to her ears, that your voice be made louder and louder in Jesus' name. That she will hear your voice, oh God, not the voice of the enemy. Burn, Holy Ghost fire. Burn those snakes in her ears. Burn those snakes in her eyes, in the front of her eyes, over her eyes, under her eyes. Burn, Holy Ghost fire. Burn. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Holy Ghost fire, go deep down into her conscience. In her mind, in her will, in her emotions, and burn. Burn out everything that is not of you. Every bit of darkness that's trying to still hold on to her mind, will, and emotions, burn, Holy Ghost fire. Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Burn, Holy Ghost fire, ransack her body. Ransack her mind in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn. Burn from the top of her head to the soles of her feet. Every single garment that she's wearing right now, Father, burn, Holy Ghost fire. Burn. Even Holy Ghost fire, go down even to her throat. Burn into her throat. Anything that is not of you, any word that might be spoken that is not of you. Holy Ghost fire, we ask for that you just burn. Burn out on your tongue in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Burn even down into her lungs. Burn, Holy Ghost fire. Every darkness, every bit of darkness, burn in Jesus' name. Burn on her breast, burn in her back, burn that snake in her back, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, snake that out her neck, burn, Holy Ghost fire, go deep down in her belly, deeper, 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 deeper down her belly. And Holy Ghost fire, burn out everything that took on the form of a sack of a snake, human, egg, insect, anything that's not of you. Burn, Holy Ghost fire, burn out all that uncleanness. Burn in the name of Jesus, burn that lust, burn that sin, burn in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, rinse, ransom, baptize. Purify and sanctify her belly. Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire continues to burn deeper down into her reproductive system, into her ovaries, into her fallopian tubes, into her uterus, into her womb. Burn, Holy Ghost fire. Burn, burn, burn. No, you will not take her ability to have children. You will not, in the mighty name of Jesus, you will not inhabit that place. We rebuke you right now, in the name of Jesus, and bind you. Get out in Jesus' name. Burn, Holy Ghost fire. Burn, burn, burn. Every plant that my Heavenly Father has not planted is rooted up right now in the name of Jesus. Burn, Holy Ghost fire. Burn every single one of those plants in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Burn, burn. Continue to go deep, Holy Ghost fire. Burn even in her rectum in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Burn in her vagina, Holy Ghost fire. Burn, burn, burn in her bladder, in her pancreas. Every single system in the name of Jesus, even in her digestive system, Lord. Burn, 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 burn her intestines. Burn, Holy Ghost. Burn, burn, purify her. Sanctify her. Purify her in the name of Jesus Christ with your blood in the name of Jesus Christ.
In Jesus' name.
Holy Ghost fire, burn even up and down her leg. Burn, 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 burn all those evil spirits that's trying to hold on and grab on her leg. Grab them, snatch them all in the name of Jesus Christ. Burn, Holy Ghost fire. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Burn, set them all ablaze in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Burn even on her feet and her toes. Take those anklets off her ankles right now in the name of Jesus. That filthy jewelry in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Get it off of her in Jesus' name. Burn even those toe rings in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Burn, 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 even under her toenails. In between her toes. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Burn, Holy Ghost fire. Burn, 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 in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Stay home. I speak to your will. Will be free in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Mind, be free in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hearing, be free in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I speak to your body. Body, be free in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Holy Ghost fire, thank you for going forth and burning. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, for setting my sister totally and completely free. And Lord, I just ask right now that you do not leave her empty. Thank you, Lord, for cleaning her. Thank you, Lord, for washing her, baptizing her, burning out and purifying everything that is not of you. But Lord, I ask that you not leave her empty. Fill her to overflow with your Holy Spirit. Fill her with your peace. Fill her with your joy. Fill her, Lord, with your knowledge. Fill her, Lord God. Fill her, fill her, fill her, fill her in the name of Jesus. And I pray, Lord, I thank you that you fill her with your confidence and courage to go forth and to share her testimony with us, Lord God, that they may be set free. Lord God, she will be able to be used by you to deliver many students
in the name of
Jesus Christ. Father, we just thank you right now. We praise you for the wonderful work that you have done.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name. Lesejo, you are free.
You're
free in Jesus' name.
Amen. You are
free. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Jesus. And you just believe by faith. And remember now, it's only your faith in God's word that you are free. That is your evidence. The evidence that he set you free is your faith in his word. It's not in what you feel, what you don't feel, because the enemy tried to deceive you with your feelings so you can open the door and let it back in. But you got to learn to rebuke that those lying feelings and thank God for setting you free and praise and worship him. Make sure you obey. Obey what he said. Okay, because you are free. He did. Go ahead.
I'm getting rid of everything right now. After this video call, I'm getting rid of everything.
You get the devil back and probably say, no. No, the curse thing. You know, you remember in the scripture where they took Dagon, I think it's Dagon, their God, and put it next to the ark of the cuff of the altar, that altar in the scripture in the Old Testament. And Colin, if you know the scripture, you can text it to me. But Dagon was their god. and the Ark of the Covenant. They put them both in the same room. So they got up, they went to bed, came back the next morning, they found they gone. They done fell down and broke into pieces.
Oh yeah, I know the scripture.
Broken into pieces. No way. God don't curse this with demons. Mm-mm. So the cursed thing, you got to get rid. You got to get rid of that cursed thing. I mean, look what Joshua did. I think it was Achan. He stole that garment and he buried it and hid it. That was a cursed thing brought into the children Israel camp. And Joshua, something was wrong because they supposed to have won that battle and nobody shouldn't have gotten killed, but it didn't happen. So he knew something was wrong, and the Lord told him, you got the cursed thing. He said, well, I don't have no cursed thing. And the Lord said, call all the tribes together. God could have just told him who it was, but the Lord went through all that process for a reason. So, long story short, wait. And that man not only got himself killed, but he got his family killed. This guy, God hate the cursed. He want nothing cursed in your space. You know, you got to get rid of, because the devil say that's his property. He believes what his property is, so he was set free. So if my sister Carla was praying, what were you experiencing as she was praying?
Well, in my mind, like, I was imagining myself touring every sexy show that I have up.
Amen. You're certain about that thing. And you're free.
Yeah, I did experience some movements here and there, especially in my legs, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Your legs. Mm-hmm. The devil had to come. They're gone. So you keep them out by continuing your faith in God's word that he set you free. Hold on to your faith in God's word. Know that he heard you, he did it, and your evidence that he did it is only in your faith in his word. He said it, he did it. That is your evidence. That's all you need. So when the devil comes trying to trick you any other way, you just don't receive it. No devil. I done got rid of all your items. You tricked me. But no more. I done got rid of all your items. You have no legal rights. And as the Holy Ghost reveals to you, open doors, you close those doors. And don't be ashamed to speak God's truth. Because they're going to ask you, because they're going to notice your change, your difference in the way you dress, they're going to ask you. So the Lord said, don't be ashamed. You tell them the truth, because those same spirits that came out of you, they are in them. Say, don't you ever feel any movement in your belly? Like something moving in your belly? They're like, yeah. Let me tell you what it is. It's demon spirit, snake, love. And only Jesus can set you free. So you got to tell people the truth. Can't hold back. If you hold back, that's the open door for the enemy to come back. So you hold back, the devil will come back. So don't hold back, okay? So if you have any more questions, you can feel free to send me an email. Okay? All right. Go ahead.
One more question. So mm-hmm. I get rid of all the pictures.
All the pictures all the pictures you have that you know you pose sexy, you look sexy in those photographs. Those are the photos you get.
Okay. And then all the clothes, everything.
And clothes too to make you feel sexy and look sexy. Because when you look at those photographs.
Mm-hmm. Even underwear, do I get rid of those?
Yeah, they got them sexy underwear too. They got those too. You get rid of those. That's why do you think you bought them? Most women don't really purchase plain, simple underwear. Mm-hmm. I remember when those broke off bones came out. I didn't know what that thing was. I said, what is that? Behind that girl back in my daughter's neck. I said, what in the world? Why do you want something between your crack like that? They wear it because they still say, well, mama, they wear it because they don't want any pattern line. I said, when we were coming up, we just wore dark, regular underwear. Not no phone. And besides, your bitch ain't got to be being that tight anyway. Yeah, you know, the bride, you wear a bride, and then you got your clothes on the bride, but in your mind, you love that bride. You know, you just barely look down at your breast because you like the way that bra cut your breast up and make you look neat. Sexy bride. Anything that you wear, well, that makes you feel and look sexy, that is of the devil. That's the god of this world.
Okay.
All right. All right now. Again, if you have any questions for later on, just send me a message and I'll respond. All right?
Okay. Thank you.
All right. So I'm going to mute you. Now, Ella or Lisa, I'm going to bring you on. Ella or Lisa.
Hello.
Hello. Her spirit said bring you on because you didn't get a chance. You didn't, yeah, you were listening. Yeah, I know you were listening, but you didn't never get a chance to share with us your testimony. And I want you to share your testimony, what you experienced during your deliberate session, during the five prayers. Share with us what you experienced and also how you've been maintaining your deliverance.
Okay. Okay, when you started the fire prayers for me, after some while, I was not myself. It's like I went mute because then I was saying amen, amen. Suddenly I went mute. I started feeling like something inside of me was trying to come out. Then my body was expanding. Then something was struggling to come out inside of me. There was like a struggle. It was like a battle. And before I knew it, inside me, I was saying, that thing inside me was like saying no, no, no. That's why I was shaking my head. It was refusing to come out. That was the reason I was shaking my head. Seriously, I was shaking my head. I knew a battle was going on. It was a serious battle. On that day of my deliverance, the network was very bad. Then when the network went off, I started making a strange sound that I've never made before in my life. I knew I was making a sound as it's like I could feel the thing inside of me crying out. So I was crying out. I was making a strange sound I've never felt before. So I logged in immediately. I logged in immediately to continue with the prayers. When I logged into the Zoom video deliverance section, you were still praying. So I joined with the prayers. I started saying amen, 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 amen. As I was saying that amen, I was still feeling something was going on inside my body. Then I felt like something came out through my mouth. Then when you finished prayer, my body felt like it has undergone a battle. Like that's undergone a battle. I said, no, my body felt a little bit tired, like someone that has gone through, when I say stress, like I knew that my body went through something. I could feel it. And I was very happy because I knew that I was delivered. I've never felt like that. All my life I've been going for deliverance prayers. I've never felt like that. I've never experienced such thing. The one that surprised me the most was that strange sound I was making.
That strange sound.
I felt like the thing inside of me was crying out, and if you tell me right now to make that sound, I cannot make it right now.
Because we're crying because it didn't want to leave.
When the network went off, I started making that strange sound. I can't even make that sound. So when you think you did it, I was shocked. I was like, does it mean that something evil was living inside of me? But I knew since I was in high school, I used to have this sex dream. See a face of a man. He takes the face of different men. He will come to me in my dream and have sex with me. And I can feel the presence of the man. He will press me down and have sex with me, but mostly in the dream. So the day he started that deliverance prayer, and after the deliverance prayer, I was shocked. I started recalling everything that happened. I was like, so all this while, I never knew that something evil was inside my body. I thought it was from outside. The attack was coming from outside. You understand? I was so happy that God delivered me. I was very, very happy. I was sharing with my friends my deliverance experience to you, and I encouraged them that they should contact you for deliverance. Because all my life I've been going to deliverance prayer. I've never experienced such manifestation in my life before.
Carla, I'm going to unmute you and ask you a question. Do you remember Ada or Lisa? It was in the group session on Zoom. She was the one. You're from Nigeria, right, Annalisa? Nigeria.
Yes.
She was the woman that that spirit was manifesting. Her head was going all crazy, and she got disconnected. And I knew by faith that those devils were coming out of her, even while we were disconnected physically, but we weren't disconnected spiritually. Do you remember her, Carla?
Annalisa? For that one, I think I didn't do the intercession for her because it was only, I think, three people who needed it. So she was only sharing, I think, right? I think Celia was there. But I did see it on
posted
it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's her. She never got a, Lord told me to bring her on because she never got a chance to share her deliverance. Because a lot of people thought she won't deliver. But by faith in the Holy Ghost, Lord Ghost told me he delivered her, even though she got disconnected. I mean, when she was disconnected, those demons were still coming out of her while we were disconnected. Mm-hmm. You see, but people didn't think she was set free, what she was. So Holy Ghost said, bring her on and let her share her testimony. She said, free. So Annalisa, how have you been maintaining your deliverance?
Well, I've been dressing modestly. I stopped wearing trousers, nice pants.
Mm-hmm.
And I stopped wearing my wigs.
Mm-hmm.
I put it up for sale. I stopped wearing wigs. I only bred. You can see, I just bred.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I asked you
about the hairstyle. I stopped applying lipstick. I only use like lip gloss to make my lips moisturized.
Yeah, she's dressing modest. And she's such a humble woman. She's humble. You know, she has asked me questions, and I said, Lord, I tell you the truth. A lot of times, I don't know how people are going to react, but I have to tell you the truth. But with Adelisa, she's so humble. She said, thank you, Mama. So respectful. Thank you, Mama. I never know when she don't like something. I never know because she's so respectful. But she do it. She obeys God's command. That's because she wants to be set free. I mean, you know, there's other things that she's involved with. She asked my opinion, which I don't give my opinion. I give the word of God, and she obeys. Now, that young man, I still haven't heard anything from that young man. Okay, so the Lord said if he contact you, that you know how to come on the FCC app, you know, educate him on that.
I've done that already. He does not know how to operate like mobile apps. So I educated him on that, how to do it. Just about 30 minutes ago, I told him how to do it.
Do you two live close together or far away?
So just far away from each other. We just communicated through phone. Yeah.
Okay.
Just told him how to maneuver the FCC app.
Well, tell him to email me, and I'll set up a date and time with him. And then when it's time, then he can talk to you, and you can sign him on.
Okay.
You know, help him to sign on and stuff, because he do need to be delivered. The devil will use his lack of learning to prevent him from coming to get delivered. Because you know what? Those same spirits that came out of you, those other spirits are in him too. That's why you two were attracted to each other. Darkness in you were attracted to him and vice versa. The same spirits are in him. And God wants to set you totally free.
Okay.
You continue to maintain your delivery. Continue to share the good news that what God has done to you in detail. Let people know. Because like you said, you did not know that evil. I did not know that evil was in me. But Jesus knows.
Okay.
And the good thing about Jesus, he knows and he does something about it. He don't leave us in that condition.
Mm-hmm.
He sent us to his chosen helper to cast those spirits out of us so we can, you know, fulfill our destiny in Him the rest of our lives. So you continue to share this with me, okay?
Okay.
Now you see how God just sent you to tune in. You didn't even know that we were going to be on. You just thought you were just testing the app. And God sent you to test the app at the right time. But you know, you never know when I'm on. And I usually block it, but Lord said, don't lock it. And I didn't lock it. And that was the reason why I didn't lock it. But when the Holy Ghost tells you to call on that app, just be obedient. I may be up there, I may not be up there.
Okay.
But just obey the Holy Ghost so you never know when I'm up here.
Okay.
All right. I want to thank all my intercessors for coming on. Now, continue to intercede for this young lady in Namibia. I can't pronounce her name. Her name is T-U-U-L-I-K-I. How do you pronounce that, Annalisa? T-U-U-L-I-K-I.
T-U.
T as in Tom. U okay. as in universe, U as in universe, L as in Larry, I, K, I.
Okay, I think it's Tuleki.
Okay, she's in Namibia, and if you listen to Tuleki, to excuse me, but if you listen, you need to make sure you come to one of the call-in deliverance sessions. I hold call-in deliverance sessions, one-on-one sessions, on Wednesdays and Thursdays at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Okay? So you just sign in on the app. But you make sure you sign in where I can see you. You have to make sure you get through on video.
On Wednesday?
That's Wednesdays and Thursdays at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Now,
okay.
The primary, I must be able to see you on video for the one-on-one session. Now,
okay.
Now, on Sundays at 3 a.m. the time, there's going to be a group session. I don't have to see you, okay? It's the audio for you. You'll see me.
Okay.
But I do warn you, and the Lord told me, make sure I warn everybody who say, okay, I'm going to come on Sundays at 3 because I won't be seen. Don't you come. Because you know what? Because those devils will leave, but when you hang on the phone, they're going to get back into you. Seven more, even worse devils will get into you. Why? Because you still hold on to your reputation. They're not giving up yourself. They're not giving your reputation. They're sin. And that sin opened the door for them to come back. So don't say, well, I'm going to come on the group stage so I don't have to be seen. Don't. Because I don't want you to be worse off after I hang up. You have to be willing to give up your reputation even when you come on an audio session. Okay? That's what the devil's going to tell people that. And the devil knows it's his game. If you come on refusing to give up your reputation, because he knows when I hang up, he got legal right to jump back into you and bring seven more visitors worse than he is back into you. Now you're worse off before you even called in. So when you call it audio, you make sure you're more just as willing to be seen as you are willing to be heard. Okay? That's for your
mm-hmm.
safety. Okay. So you
okay.
Let there you go, Carla. Okay, let me see Carla back on. All right. I see you now. What did you do, Carla?
I had to go into my settings and allow the camera
for
this website. It's weird. I've never had that problem.
Lily, did you hear that? Maybe that's what you have to do, Lily. Could you send me those instructions on an email? And literally, I email you those instructions. Do you remember, young lady said that you may have to go into your settings on your phone or computer, go to your settings to allow the webcam. So if you send me, Carla, those instructions, I'll send it to Lil, because she have a problem coming on video as well.
Okay?
That'll be great. All right, that's a pass. Well, thank everybody for showing up, the intercessors, thank you, your prayers and her, and continue to keep my sister from Namibia in prayer, because that strong man needs to come out, because if not, it's going to kill her. His aim is to physically heal her. So you go, you really go in prayer for her. Okay? All right now, everybody stay blessed in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Shalom.